Addressing a press conference at Parliament while clad in black, MPs castigated actions and conduct of the security personnel under the command of the resident district commissioners, which are made to block them from interfacing with their constituencies.
Honestly, we don't have Uganda police. It is NRM. Because why do they always go for the opposition, leaving other members to freely do their activities? I call upon the security that if you want to show Ugandans that you are fed up of the regime, don't inflict your angry actions on the opposition members. Just be open and tell Ugandans that we are tired of the regime.
Victims of brutality, including Joyce Bagala, the Mityana Woman MP, Kaya Christine Nachimwero, Chiboga District Woman MP, Florence Kabugo, Kasese Woman MP, Betty Ethel Naluima, the Wakiso Woman MP, Joan Achom Alobo from Soroti City, and Asnas Nyakato, the Hoima City Woman MP, with the most recent being Susan Mugabe, the woman representative of Buvuma District, who is still nursing wounds. Female legislators want the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, to lead them in a demonstration to show dissatisfaction over the violation of the rights of women.
It's not about parties, but being in opposition is issue-based. And I wish all of us to embrace this activity. The IRCCs of Soroti City are on record for saying they will never allow an opposition member to carry out a function as long as they are in Soroti City. Where do they get these powers from?
I've gotten all the clearance from the security offices, right out from the RDC, the RPC, the DPC, and everyone concerned. Unfortunately, on the D-Day, I saw security coming all over and disrupting the function. I was like, what is this? I'm supporting the government to skill the young ones, but where did I go wrong, honestly?
We took a petition to the speaker, and we had a number of prayers. One of them was for her as a woman leader to lead a demonstration. And she said, while she may not be able to lead the demonstration, but she's going to lead the move to ensure that everything we've asked for is going to be dealt with. And she has assured us that there's going to be action taken against all the people involved, and that she's going to write immediately to all the ministers we've talked about for them to appear in Parliament.
They also demand that ministers for presidency, internal affairs and gender present comprehensive reports to the House detailing their concerns and what they have done in this gross violation of the rights of women and the Constitution. They also want security officers, RDCs and RCs involved in the assault of all the affected MPs to be prosecuted personally before the courts of law.
If the police is saying they've taken their officers to the standards unit, it is not enough. We said prosecution. They should be taken to court. They are breaking the law. They are violating the Constitution. They are criminals.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.